Hi, I'm Jordan, and this is Amazing Graze Boards. Today, I'm gonna be showing you how to build a charcuterie, and this is gonna be perfect for the Christmas season. So if you have a small group gathering this year, then this is a board that you definitely wanna make, and it's super simple. I've got ingredients. I'm gonna walk you through how to put them all together to build an amazing board. If you love videos like this, and you wanna learn how to entertain your guests with beautiful boards, then consider subscribing. Okay, let's start off with what you will need to build this board. So first, you're going to need a round board because we're gonna work along the edges for this wreath. And I don't normally talk about it, but usually I add a food grade mineral oil to the board that I have because when you use these wooden boards, they dry out. So the more you use them and wash them, they just tend to dry out, and so other foods can stick to it. So just pick up a mineral oil. I've got this on Amazon, so I'll link it below if you are interested in getting one for yourself. So I'm gonna start with our decorative items after the board. So what I'm gonna be building underneath our food is a layer of mixed eucalyptus as well as some Christmas greenery. And I found these both, I've seen them at multiple grocery stores, so you will definitely be easily able to find something like that. But I'm also gonna add some herbs too. So I'm gonna be adding in some rosemary and sage for different textures along this round wreath area. So another decorative item that I'll be putting is these tiny little pine cones that I found. I found like a bag at Target for about $4 or $5. Came with way more than this, but I just figured I needed the smallest size. So to move on to our fruits, you're going to need any type of grape. I chose green because I want to try to keep with a green wreath color, but you can definitely use red grapes as well because I did also pick up some organic fresh cranberries. So you can easily interchange a cranberry for a green or a red grape as well. So I also found these mini organic apples at Whole Foods. This is the only place I was able to find them. I just thought it would be a nice addition to the board since it's earthy and it's I'm gonna keep it in its whole state. So another option I might use is raspberries. And that just depends on how much room I have left. I may or may not use those. I might add fresh raspberry jam instead of fresh raspberry. So I will either choose one or the other, and you can do the same thing. You can interchange a different fruit or a different jam, whichever you'd prefer on your board. So moving on to some little condiments, I'm going to add some green olives in a ramekin. I'm not sure which color I'll use, but I'm gonna try and find a space if I can to add those, as well as caramelized pecans. This is gonna be a beautiful glazy color to it. And then I found these cinnamon stars at Cost Plus World Market. I wanted to add a star cookie on there. I found different ones. They're shortbread star cookies. I can even find some at Trader Joe's. So I'm sure tons of companies right now are putting out little star cookies. So I thought that would be really cute to add to that. So onto our cracker, I'm just gonna add fig and olive crisps. These are one of my favorites. You can grab these at Trader Joe's, but there are other companies that make these in different flavors as well. So that will be the only cracker I use. So on to the meat, I have two options. I'm gonna use a salami, a cured salami, and then I'm gonna use prosciutto. So I'm gonna be wrapping these up kind of in a little rose design. And then the prosciutto, I'm just gonna kind of lay folded on certain areas where I find space. And so today I'm only using two cheeses since it is going to be smaller just because you're not gonna fill the whole board, it's only the outer rims. So this is a goat cheese. It's called bijou. I've never had it before. It's actually, they're mini. They're these little mini cheeses, but I'm gonna cut them in half and use them and place them along the board in different areas. And then this is a 1,000-age Gouda cheese. This is by far my top three favorite cheeses of all time. One, it's inexpensive for an aged Gouda, but it's just got so much flavor and that crystallization that you really like. So it goes good with cured meats, olives, any type of fruit. It goes really well with a lot of different cheeses. So that's my choice. And that's it. So all of these will be put together and I'm gonna get started right now. Okay, so here we are starting to lay the greenery down. I started with, I think, this like spruce basic greenery, but it wasn't full enough. So I started to layer them on top of one another and that looked a lot better. So I just wanted to make sure that you could barely see the board underneath, since of course we are adding more food, so I didn't need to overly do it. But I'm showing you this small piece of parchment paper that I cut up in little squares to place underneath the cheese, so that if you're uncomfortable feeding your guests on top of greenery or spruce, then you can easily just like add a little piece. I'm normally fine with it, but I know that some people, you know, might want to make their guests feel very comfortable. So here I am cutting the salami that I got from Trader Joe's. It's a longer, thin slice of salami, so I cut them lengthwise, and basically I layer one on top of the other, almost kind of like a train. Like I put it towards the end and layer the other one towards the other end of it, and then I roll it up so it looks like a roll slash rose. I mean, these don't really look like roses, but it just gives the impression of it. So I add them two together. See, here I am rolling it up lengthwise like a little train. And then on the other two, I'm gonna add prosciutto next to it. So you wanna make sure that you're just, I also added, if I didn't mention, the little paper underneath the meats as well. So there's like a tiny square underneath each meat. And then I put them under this gouda as well. Again, just to make you or your guests comfortable. So this cup that I was using to add the olives onto, the rim of the cup was just too, I don't know. It was very obvious when I put it on the board. So I cut the rim off since it was a little plastic cup. And so now you can barely see what's holding the olives, but that needed to be there. So I added the green grapes, the candied walnuts, and I'm also going to start to just kind of fan and like lay the prosciutto, not anything perfect or beautiful. I just kind of like slightly fan and folded it and then just laid it there. So the raspberries, I forgot to add the crackers onto this charcuterie. So you could easily replace the raspberries with the crackers and then lay the raspberries in random spots for, you know, the berry feel or the little berry theme that usually goes with that. So then here I am adding the decorative, the little pine cones and the stars. Now I'm adding some more raspberry and some of the sage leaves as the finishing touches. I did not add the cranberries just because I knew that they would start falling off since it was getting really full, but you could easily replace the raspberries with the cranberries or vice versa. So that was my charcuterie. So I hope you guys enjoy it. It was beautiful and very delicious. So hope you guys like this video, and I will see you in the next one.